Medicine Outlet. We are North Carolina's only punk band with two references to Upton Sinclair. This song is called The Jungle, and it's about me.
Yeah.
say we write a lot of songs about why you shouldn't masturbate. And I think it's because we write a lot of songs about why you shouldn't masturbate. The last one was about how God doesn't want you to masturbate. This one is about how the government doesn't want you to masturbate.
It's true.
That's why they gave us cornflakes. Look up cornflakes.
Anything having to do with John Kellogg or the Ralston Corporation? Yeah, no, cornflakes were invented to destroy your sex drive, as were everything by Ralston Purina Corp back in the 30s. They also believed that watermelons were poisonous to Caucasians, which seems suspect because I've known a couple of white people who enjoy watermelon and it doesn't really seem like they were negatively impacted by it.
Alright, this is called We Want Police.
I'm gonna go
Yeah.
This next one is about the cloak.
Oh yeah, the reason you thought that was Bruce Springsteen is he was wearing the coat of Laban.
Yes, why not?
Yes. Alright. I guess you've all heard that they've had to start reducing the fluoride levels in our drinking water because my wife's such a fucking bitch, she puts it in there.
Yeah!
So this song is about her fucking up our water supply. We are going to do it just not right this second. This song is called Nobody Likes Tina. Does anybody here know who Tina Weymouth is? Well, she's the bass player for the Talking Heads. And I found out.
And the Tom Tom Club, right?
Yeah, the Tom Club. I've read it on the internet. Tina Weymouth put together the Sandy Hook shootings to jumpstart the Tom Tom Club's career. Look it up. This song is about her.
Thank you.
Portamento Strip.
Yeah. Man, you gotta watch out for that Portamento Strip, man. Next thing you know, you'll be drinking Sprite and shit.
What is it with you and Sprite?
Mormons aren't allowed to drink caffeine.
Oh, Sprite doesn't have caffeine in it.
What?
Sprite doesn't have caffeine in it.
Right.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I actually watched a documentary in the Austin in England, and they showed their catering. The hotel guy actually brought six Sprites to them, so I know what I'm talking about. We're gonna try to attempt a seance here, okay? Alright, you never
know. This might not work.
Yeah. Sometimes you get something good, you know?
Sometimes you get Hitler.
One time we got fucking Reba McEntire's band. That was awkward.
Well, just the horn section.
Just the horn section, yeah. Tonight we're gonna try to summon L. Tom Perry. I don't know if you read or not, but he's the second highest ranked member of the Mormon Church and he died this week. Yeah, he's going home.
He got his own fucking planet.
Oh, yeah. It's called Perius or some shit.
Huh?
I'm just talking.
Oh, it's his planet? I thought you were with the song.
So here we go. We're going to try to summon Mel Tom Perry.
Oh,
by supporting the troops that we don't step on a Chinese-made magic flag. This is our country song, so since we're in a country bar, like, if we feel at home here.
Let's go.
mood is next. More songs. This song is about how Kevin wants to be president.
Elder.
Elder of Dungarees.
Elder Dungarees in 2004.
Yeah. Okay. If the key gets elected, we will have our first white president.
Whoa. Yeah, I know, right?
What? Oh yeah, that's Japanese dungarees power. I'm just dumb power. And that's Jerry Deere power.
Or John Deere power.
Yeah. All right, so the song's called Oval Orifice.
You don't want to be associated with corporate greed. Just asses.